So we're here at the ID TechEx show, and hi, so who are you?
I'm Rahim. I'm from company ElastiSense.
So what do you do here?
Yeah, we are specialized in mechanically flexible displacement sensors. So they are basically sensors that can measure positions of a structure or a machine while it's tolerant to different kind of movements. It's based on a smart rubber technology, which is essentially a rubber material which changes its parameters when it's being stretched, electrical parameters, and that's basically the core component in the sensors, which is being measured. And as you can see here, that's the sensor signal. So as I stretch, you can see the signal being changed, and it can change in all directions.
And in all directions?
Yeah, I mean, it's because if you can stretch it in all directions, it will change its signals.
Is it 360 degree sensing?
It cannot dissolve all three dimensions, but it could certainly measure all three dimensions, depending.
And do you sell like a kit with different sizes?
Or? Yeah, exactly. And we produce them in different sizes, and we also produce data acquisition units and the softwares. And as you could see here, the sensors could be used in different kind of applications. Could be in heavy vehicles, in structural health monitorings, in processing machines, and so on, for monitoring and control of applications.
Nice. And what do you have over there?
Well, this is our sister company.
On the side.
Excuse me.
What is this?
This is our sister company that produces the core rubber material. So here is, for example, the dough strain gauges in a different patterns for different applications being made. Here we have the core components, the rubber strain gauge, as you can see. It's being stretched, and you can see the signal there in computer being changed. So that is the core component now, which we saw in the other sensors, now here for itself, as you can see.
And what is this?
So this is the measurement unit. It actually take the change of electrical signal from the sensors and convert it into some kind of transmittable values, digitally or in analog.
And on the here you have
here we could measure up to four sensors.
It's just micro
in the same
USB.
Time. Yes, so they are micro USB sensors, and we have them charging in output units as well.
And you say sixth company?
Yes, we are a group. This is the original company developing the core technology, and then ElastiSense is somehow a spin out of this company focusing only on industrial applications.
And you've been doing this for a long time, or?
We as a founders of the company have been doing this since 2008. And the company has been existing since 2013.
And is this world exclusive technology? Nobody else do this?
Oh yeah, there are a couple of other companies, one in US and one in New Zealand, that produce the same kind of or use the same kind of technology to make sensors.
But you have the best.
Well, that's what we think so.
Yeah. Do you have? Is this a big market or?
Well, as you could see, the use cases for the technology is quite large. It's not confined to a single niche or a specific market sectors. It could be applied in all kind of industries, wearables, industrial, structural, and so on. So the market interface is quite large.
It looks like something that could be in a car.
It can. And we already have some cases. We are working with some tier one supplier to automotive companies to integrate the technology.
And what they do in the car with this?
Well,
measure exactly
I cannot disclose
how
that
far the wheel is from.
I cannot disclose that. They are under some NDAs conditions, those nice. Applications.
All right. Yeah. And a lot of potential.
Quite a lot of potential,
but it's
yes.
all related to this stretchable sensor.
Exactly. It's this mechanical properties of the sensors that makes it quite useful in different kind of application. It enables quite a lot of new applications where strain gauges or sensor could not be used before.
And is this very precise?
Yes, our sensors there is 0.1% of full-scale accuracy.
Well, and does this look like something that's 3D printed and print electronics? So,
yeah,
how do you make this?
Well, I mean, we have we get supplied some silicon sheets, and then we print our own conductive layers on top of it, and then we keep doing it three times. So there are three conductive layers and four non-conductive layers alternating on top of each other.
And the material is?
Silicones.
Silicones.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So it's not the same you have in rubber, or is it the same?
Well, rubber, you have some rubbers or silicones, basically.
Okay. Cool. All right.
Yes.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.